Hello, YouTube Bears, it's Cynthia and Michael from School Introductions, bringing you a new podcast for my 7th call, the Naruto Reveal. And like always, I'm going to speak very loudly, very clearly, and very slowly in case you don't understand me. And also, I will do my best not to breathe so hard during this recording of this audio podcast, and also try not to try not to be so hard causing any audio feedback during this recording of this audio podcast. Now, in case you want to make that noise in the background, my roommate is in the living room watching a movie. So basically, this is the only time I can do this podcast. So basically, I will try to do my best to speak up more loudly, and also just to let you know that this is my roommate in the living room watching the TV. But I'm sure he will try to keep TV noise down to a minimum. So anyway, let's get into the latest episode of Naruto Shippuden. Now the way this episode starts off, Black Shetsu was still telling Naruto and Sasuke the story about Lady Kakarot, who managed to mobilize them with Black Shetsu. Black Shetsu told. So anyway, Black Shetsu continued Lady Kakarot's story. You know, after her two sons were born, to Haruo and Hama. So basically, everything was, you know, basically a couple of years passed by, whatnot, you know, Hanaro, a young man now, wondering about
certain things about their mother and whatnot. So anyway,
everything has been calling the land of Soul and Kai. But like, she took over the land of Soul and Kai, and looked like she ain't been using her secret union juice or anybody who's left and whatnot. So anyway, one of the servants told them that something's wrong with the river. So anyway, when they got to the river, they noticed that the water, there was this little stream where the river is supposed to be, and Hana went up to investigate why the water is wrong with the river water flow. So anyway, Hana uses his Byakugan powers to scout ahead and saw a big boulder. Blocking the river. So basically, before they're about to remove the boulder, this toad on the small boulder was talking to him and Haruo and Hana looking like they must be bugging, they thought they heard that toad talk, but it turns out the toad is Ginyumaro. Now, if you don't know who the fuck Ginyumaro is, I'm not gonna explain it to you. So basically, you have to go. You guys, I ain't gonna explain nothing to you like that. So explain who Ginyumaro is. That's too much backstory for me to explain who Ginyumaro is. Anyway.
Grandma Marvel was the toad who he was the toad who put the giant Bodhi there for a reason, that way he can talk to them. But you know, didn't, but out of nowhere this bear interrupted him and Grandma Marvel used his powerful toad stream back, and it sent that bear flying through the fucking woods like it was nothing. So Grandma Marvel was like, you know, let's go somewhere else and talk. So anyway, so Hoggle and Hano went and followed the toad somewhere to go talk, but Hakuo used Shidori to destroy the boulder and the river, and the waterfall to the river was restored. So anyway, so they got to this mountain, this clearing that shows you the area where the divine tree at. So basically, she was asking them, do you guys know about the divine tree? No. Did your mother tell you about the divine tree? No, she never tells us about the divine tree, and also, we're not allowed to go near the bond tree by Mother's Law. So basically, Grandma Marvel is telling them that the bond tree is doing it or nature's. The natural power of nature, making the natural powers of nature being dry as a wax. So basically, if that tree continues to fly, soon this whole area will be dead, and so this whole fucking planet. So basically, Grandma was like saying, your mother's not telling you the whole truth about what the real purpose of about the divine tree's powers and whatnot. And basically, let's see, Hano is not thinking, mom would never do something to be, never lie to us, like nothing like that. So basically, they're not buying what Gamma Maro is saying. So basically, they think he's just a crazy talking nonsense against their mother. So anyway, when they got back to the village, you know, their mother was on the way on business. But a traveling sales merchant who specialized in herbs and shit was looking for Lady Cockwell, looked like he had some business to him, but that's when Hano showed up and turns out he didn't have no business. Turned out he was just a salesman trying to get in their mother's good graces. That way he can get in the good graces, that way he can get a part of a bank from the divine tree and whatnot and sell it for more money. But basically, Hano chased him off and whatnot, and suddenly he's attacking. But Hano, tracked the guy down and whatnot, and hit his back and whatnot, and asked him, how's the other line see my mother, and the message, and the other line see my your mother is seen like a tyrant and whatnot, you know, whatnot. And so basically he got Harold got his answer to the message and told the message said, don't ever come back here. Don't ever come back here or try to go near the divine tree. So basically, the next day passed, they, you know, how and Hana was doing the tours of the village. They see a group of people who is about to be part of the divine tree, which they don't know shit about. And among these people was the servant girl that how had feelings for. Telling that, you know, I've been chosen to be a part of the divine tree ritual, you know, and she was basically telling Hana and Ho that, you know, me not never see each other again. He get Ho her necklace, and you know, just to remember her by whatnot. So basically, they were still, you know, they don't know jack shit about the vine tree ritual. So basically, later that day, they told their mother, like, you know, can you spear Hala? Hala, that's her name. Hala, you know, from the ritual, it's like, and the mother said, no, I can't do that. So basically, she's chosen to be a part of the ritual. So therefore, who am I to change it? And so basically, even with the trees and whatnot, to preach to her mother about that. Letting Hala slide from the divine tree ritual, you know, like how their mother say hell no. So basically, she said no, and she also told them that you guys should not be so emotional over a low-life person like that. You know, basically, she said in a very cold manner, in a very cold way. So anyway, So later that night, the next day when the mother was away on the way on another business trip somewhere, she saw Haku and Hana decided to go to the divine tree and school what their mother said, you know, and trying to find their friend. When they got to the divine tree, Hana used his Byakugan powers to scan the trees, and he saw these pods with people in it, and he found his friend. So basically, they opened the pod where the friend is at, and Hana was trying to wake her up for Hana told Haro that she's already dead, and that way to pissed him off soon. And fixed them off, and they finally realized that Jamie Mao was right about her mother and whatnot. So that's when Hana got his Shanagan activated. So basically, they tracked down Jimmy Mao, and it was like, you know, basically, how can we stop the divine tree? Stop the divine tree. That way, nobody else can suffer the fate of suffered the same fate, and the toad came along and was like, "Oh, I follow me." So it took him to Sage, it took him to the land of the toad, or I like to call it Sage Face, you know, and was telling him, "Oh, the two stop at the bond tree, you must be able to feed your mother," and Hano was like, "That's suicide," but Gamma was saying, Hano was the only one closer. Out of both of them, was the only one who has the capability to feed her mother and whatnot, and they thought that the bond tree, you know, from destroying the world and all that bullshit. So basically, Game of Mario told how to use the power of the Sage power and whatnot. While Hano covered for him, during his secret training. So basically, a few years go by. Hano was, turning the village, you know, while Hollow was turning with Game of Mario, but that's when his mother showed up and asked, "Where's your brother at?" And Hollow was like, he was somewhere else. To turn the different part of the village, and Kakko was like, "I know you're lying." So basically, she asked him, Byakugan tried to get him to tell the truth and shit, but he's in his Byakugan to trying to stop her mother and use her Byakugan to make her tell the truth, make him tell the truth and shit, but Kara was like, "Oh, you really could. You're trying to use your Byakugan to stop me to make you the truth, but my Byakugan is more superior than yours." And this is how the episode ended. So basically, if you want to know who the fuck Game of Mario is, I suggest you catch up on your reading and whatnot. If you don't know who Game of Mario is, so basically, I suggest you guys catch up on your reading about, on your Naruto reading and whatnot. That way, you guys can get a better idea. Because if I explain who Game of Mario is, it'll be a long fucking story. It'll be a long fucking backstory to that shit. But anyway, this episode was a good episode. It shows you the reason why Lady Kakarot's son when it gets her and whatnot and etcetera and etcetera. So basically, it was a good episode. So anyway, like always, since you're Michael from Screw You Productions, sign off. 1.